Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will start with the same lesson, equatorial region. In the last lectures we have studied about the location of the equatorial region, how is the climate in the equatorial region, and also we have studied about the plant life and the animal life in the equatorial region. Today we are going to study about the human life in the equatorial region. Now, how is the human life in the equatorial region? Now, as the equatorial region is very thinly populated because of the dense forest region. Now, why it is thinly populated? Because of the dense forest, because it is very difficult for the people to live in such a dense forest, and also because of the dense forest the area is dark and very humid throughout the year. Now some areas of the Amazon basin, Zaire Congo basin and many large islands of the Indonesia and Philippines also have very sparse population because of the dense forest. Now the tribes, the people who live in the equatorial forest region, some of the tribes are Bantu tribes found in the Zaire basin, and many large islands of Indonesia also have the very sparse population. Now the Sumatra, the island, the Indonesian island Sumatra also has Java and the Kubus tribe. These two tribes are the inhabitants of the equatorial forest region. So Bantu tribe and Java and Kubus, these are the tribes which are found in the equatorial region. Now how these people survive in such a dense forest? Now what is their occupation? Their occupation is rearing animals, collecting the forest products and all these things. Now slowly and gradually the development has taken place, and these people have moved towards the little bit development and to a civilized, they are living in a civilized manner. The agricultural activities practiced in the equatorial region are of two types, shifting agriculture and plantation agriculture. Now what is shifting agriculture? Like in shifting agriculture, crops like maize, jowar and cassava are grown after clearing a patch of forest, by clearing the patch of forest, that is the piece of the land. After a time when the fertility of the land diminishes, they move to the another place for the cultivation. So this is about the shifting agriculture. And what is plantation agriculture? In plantation agriculture, the crops like tea, coffee, rubber, means the crops which are used for the commercial purpose are grown in abundance. So mostly the crops grown in the plantation agriculture are used for the commercial purpose. So these are the two types of agricultural activities practiced in the equatorial region. So this is about the human life. In short, we can say that the equatorial region has a very sparse population because of the dense forest, and some of the tribes found in the Zaire Congo basin are Bantu tribes, and the islands of Indonesia, that is the Sumatra island, has Java and Kubus tribes, and these people survive, they earn their livelihood in the forest itself and they live their life. So this is about the human life, and also we have studied about the agriculture, which type of agricultural activities are practiced in the equatorial region. So children, today we have completed the lesson equatorial region. We have studied about the location, climate, plant life and the human life in the equatorial region. So today we will conclude the lesson by this lecture. Thank you.